what I want to work on is defenseman or number 9. We're going to be working with some people on flexibility and some people working on not as flexible. Plus, we're going to work on position of the body, position of the kicks as we do it. He punches in. Hang on. Work on block, grab, and come in. Front ball kick to the solar plexus. Keep my knee at the exact same level. Don't want to be dropping my leg down because that takes a little bit too much momentum to get it back up. So I want to kick it out and I keep it right there. Then from right here, I'm going to twist my hips. Keep my leg chambered close to my butt as I do it. Then I'm going to come in. I'm going to do a roundhouse ball kick right to the person's temple. Then I'm going to pull it right back in. Then I'm going to step down so I can regain my balance just in case I lose a little bit of my balance. Then from right here, I'm going to keep that hand and I come up with my right hand, breaking or damaging the wrist, trying to tweak it a little bit. Then from right here, I'm going to twist. I'm going to lift my knee up. The knee is in position now, the legs as we do it. And we're going to do a side thrust kick right to the floating wrist. And I want to step down, cross over, on guard. Now let's say we don't have the flexibility. Let's say when we're doing defense number 9, you can't kick someone in the head. Or you're not flexible enough to kick them in the sore points. What we can make number 9 do is adapt to a lower kick. So if he punches in, I'm going to work on block. If I have to, I can kick the person right in the groin with a nice, beautiful front ball kick. I think I'm buckling forward. But then I also can go, if I have to, a roundhouse kick right to the knee. Step down, that's going to keep him holding on. And then I'm going to grab the wrist. If I can't get my kick up to the rib, I can also come down and do a kick right to the front of the knee again, hyperextending them. Crossover.